know this looks weird. It looks really weird. We got the black couch. We have the girl. It looks really bad, but I promise this is not that type of video. Yeah, my name Telly, I ain't talking about the store. Back it up, I need a couple more. Bitches to my son, they gon' need a couple chores. Leave my trip right here, have a mouth on the floor. Nigga, I'm a begging on the set. Nigga, you a rookie, I'm a vet. Talking that shit until I'm pulling out the tech and how that motherfucker spitting at your motherfucking neck. Bitch, Telly Bo, clean you a mess. Want a late night cream, fuck around and y'all, I look a fucking mess. But I think it's time for us to have a conversation. I have to put it down here because...
Bruh.
Yeah. I'm getting ready right now. This is just besides the point. We have to have a conversation. I have not posted a real YouTube video in a long time. And this happens literally every time I make a comeback on YouTube because your girl's always disappearing and coming back and having an excuse as to why I disappeared. But... I could explain, okay? So, I'm just trying to figure out if I should do my makeup and then talk, or if I should do my makeup first and then come back, because child, I can't be looking like this. So, you know what? Since I don't have anywhere to put my phone right now, and I look crusty, I'm not gonna do this to y'all. So let me get ready, and then we're gonna have a little conversation as to where the fuck has Asia been. And what's going on in Asia's life, okay? So we gonna have a little chat. Let me get ready, hold on. Oh shit. Okay, so I'm back and I'm all done up, kind of. My hair looks a mess still, but it's whatever. So it's time to have a conversation, a little talk about what the fuck has been happening in my life and where have I been for the past, I don't know how long. Like, I know I've been releasing hair videos, but that's not real content. And you guys have been asking for like real videos and like, when's the next YouTube channel? Where have you been? Are you okay? Everything, which I appreciate. Thanks for asking. And I have to give y'all a freaking explanation. Y'all know me, like every time I disappear and come back, I always have to come back with an explanation as to where a nigga has been. Like, I know y'all be saying stuff like you don't have to let people know what's going on, which I am aware of that, but I feel like y'all have the right to know just like a little bit of what's been happening, so y'all don't think I'm just I don't know, not caught it, period. Just so that y'all think I'm not just not doing content because I don't want to, because that's not the case, okay? So, Lord. Where do we even begin? A lot has happened, y'all. Like, a lot. So, basically, as some of y'all may know already, if you follow me on Instagram, at @dripdoll_, you probably already know, I left Atlanta. No longer living there. A lot of people wanted an update video on, like, my move to Atlanta from my original video, which was how I moved to a new state with no money, no car, blah, blah, blah. A lot of y'all wanted an update about that. So, I guess I could just tie the two in here. So basically, Atlanta was just not the place for me. It wasn't what I thought it would be, and which is fine. I have never really been to Atlanta. I never lived there before previously. I haven't even visited before I moved, you feel me? I just knew that Atlanta has such a good rep for being the Black Hollywood and just so much, you know, successful Black people come up out of Atlanta, which is true. So I was like, I want to be a part of that, which is why I decided to move to Atlanta from my hometown of Rochester, New York. Because in Rochester, there's nothing going on there at all. It's hard to make it out of Rochester. So people be like, the first chance you get out. And that's exactly what I did. And I traveled to Atlanta. So when I got there, a lot of it was being gentrified. I don't know if I said it right, but like a lot of things were not there anymore. And it was just, Atlanta was more of a party city. Like, a lot, from my experience, a lot of things closed really early. The only things that were still open were the nightclubs, probably the hookah lounges, you feel me? Things like that. Like, the nightlife was good in Atlanta, but I'm not that type of person. Like, I don't care to party. I don't ever go out. Nothing. Like, the restaurants were closed at like 8, 9 o'clock. There was really nothing really fun to do besides going out. So I just decided, after being there for a year, I just decided it wasn't the place for me. I don't want to stay any longer. Like, it's time for me to get up and go to the next place. So was Atlanta worth the move? I would honestly say no. Because also with my apartment, I don't know if you guys seen my other update video when I disappeared and came back. In that update video, I kind of gave y'all like a little insider of what was happening in my apartment building and how I was being basically harassed. So yeah, that was not fun. And for that to be like my first, for that to be my first apartment alone, it wasn't a good experience at all. And it is what it is. It was a learning experience. I'm out of there and that's all that matters. So was Atlanta worth the move? No, but I kind of am happy for the experience because I got to leave the state by myself and I did everything for myself. Got my apartment by myself, got my job, had my money on my own. Like, everything was all me. So I was grateful for that aspect of everything. But as for everything else that happened in Atlanta, not worth it. At all. If I could go back in time and change it, I would. So there's that. That's why I left Atlanta. And I just wasn't happy there, y'all. Like, I was not happy. So many negative things happened in Atlanta that being there literally made me depressed. Like, it didn't feel like home. Like, yes, I was in my own apartment that I leased with my name on it. Even though it was my own home, it did not feel like home. It just felt like I was just there. So yeah, I was really depressed, and like, when I get depressed, I don't like making content. Like, you can't get me to make no content when I'm feeling down, because I like to be in my best mood when I'm doing YouTube and TikTok and taking pictures. Like, I like to feel good because then my real energy and my real personality comes out that y'all all know and love. So yeah, like, I just wasn't feeling it. So that's why I went MIA for so long. So after I left Atlanta, I was going to go back home to New York, but then some stuff happened. It's personal, so I'm not going to get into that, but I ended up not going to New York and I was stuck in Charlotte, North Carolina, which I just left from. And there, it was so much going on there. My cousin, thankfully, she took me in, but there was not enough room for me. So it's like, I didn't really have any privacy to really sit down and do my videos. And then I was struggling. I couldn't find a job because I was only there for a short amount of time. So I couldn't find a job in time. I had to give up my car. My car was getting shipped back to New York and I couldn't even go back to New York. And there was also a lot of stuff wrong with it to the point where I couldn't even really drive it for real. So I lost my car and it was, y'all, it was so terrible. I couldn't find a job. I wasn't making any content. So the money load, and I'm being very transparent with y'all. Like, I'm not gonna lie about nothing. This has been the most difficult time that I've ever had in a very, very long time. Like, I'ma just flat out say that. So yeah, shit's been really getting to your girl. Like, I've been going through it, okay? So yeah, Charlotte happened. I was only there for, I believe, 3 weeks, almost a month. Yeah, almost a month. So still very depressed. I felt like I was a burden. I felt like I was in somebody's space. Granted, I was invited there, but after you have your own shit, you don't want to go back to being into somebody else's shit. Like, you want to go into your own things. But obviously I can't have that right now. So I was in my head a lot, overthinking, just extremely, extremely stressed, like feeling like a burden. I was getting into it with people and it was just like, bro, is this the tower moment that my tarot cards talked about? Because bitch, I feel it. Like, definitely feel it. Is this my karma from something I did or something? Because yeah, it's kicking my ass right now. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. So I've been going through it, y'all. So now I left Charlotte and I am now in Los Angeles. I done moved to Cali and I'm very, very excited for this new journey. Like, I'm trying to bust out videos like this, okay? Because this is where I really want to be, and being an influencer is what I really want to do. And it's not like I don't have the platform. I have a small platform, but it's still a platform. I have 30k on IG, I have 17k on here, I have damn near 60k on TikTok. Like, I have a platform. It's a growing platform. And it's like, I really want to start using it so I can give myself more opportunities and be in a better spot. Like, I'm telling myself, 6 months from now, I will be in a better spot. And my next update video is gonna be me in my own place. I have a new car, like money in the bank. I'm doing good things. Like, that's what my next update video will be within the next 6 months, I promise you. But right now, it's grind time. Like, I'm gonna be busting out videos. Even if I'm just walking down the street, just holding the camera, talking to y'all, giving y'all vlogs and like content like that, I'm going to do it. Like, it's go time. I don't ever, when I say I don't ever, I mean I don't ever want to be in this position ever again. Like, I want to be straight. I want to be content. I want to be financially stable. I want to be genuinely happy. I don't want to be stressed, okay? Don't want to be stressed. But that's what was happening with me. I was really bouncing around and I was going through it mentally, y'all. Like, this has been a very, very, very difficult mental battle for me. I've overcame a lot worse. Like, this ain't even the first time I've been in a situation like this. I was in a situation like this beginning of 2020. Yeah, beginning of 2020, I had no money, no car. I was living in somebody else's apartment in Atlanta, and COVID happened, sent me back home. And then that's when I was really, you know, that's when things started happening for me and I got everything all over again. And then now it's kind of like the beginning of 2020 situation happening all over again at the end of 2021. So it only makes sense that the beginning of 2022, your girl is gonna be good again. Like, that's what I'm manifesting. By my birthday, your girl is gonna be good. My birthday, February 14th. So hold me to it, y'all. Hold me to it, because this is the challenge that I'm giving myself. So yeah, I'm talking a lot, y'all. I'm sorry, but that's just the update of what's been going on with me right now in Los Angeles. Don't have a car, don't have my own place, don't have a job. I just got here. Your girl's not slacking. I just got here like 4 days ago. So, but I've really been on it while I was out here. So I should be good by February. But y'all, it's so hard to get a job these days. I haven't worked in so long because I was an influencer. Like, I was taking care of myself without needing a job. But since I stopped doing my videos and shit, I kind of fucked myself up like that. So now I'm like, I need a job temporarily just to get me going again. And plus in Cali, I realized a lot of promoters pay you through PayPal. And like, a lot of apartments don't accept like PayPal stubs as like a, they don't really accept PayPal stubs as a source of income. So either way it goes, I was gonna have to get a job regardless, unless I was making like 10K on YouTube a month, which I'm clearly not doing yet. We gonna get there though. But yeah, that's basically everything that was happening to me summed up in like a little video. So that's the update there. Nothing really much has been going on because, like I said, I just got to Cali. And I am, in case anybody cares, I am doing better mentally. You know, I still have my moments where I lay down and I'm just upset because I went from having everything to having nothing. But that's life. I can't change the past. I'm not going to dwell on it because I will drive myself insane by dwelling on it. So I'm just only trying to work towards making things better for me. So yeah, mentally I'm getting better. I'm not saying I'm completely there, but I'm getting better. I'm feeling better enough to come back and create content and like be myself on the camera. So I'm a lot better than what I was previously because your girl wasn't doing shit. So we working on it. We working on ourselves mentally. We're gonna get there. So yeah, I have to go back into my manifestation journal. I'm about to write out my YouTube schedule of like what days I'm gonna upload, because I do want to upload about 3 or 4 days a week. Since I'm not working right now, I have plenty of time on my hands. So I'm trying to upload at least 3 or 4 times a week until I get a job. And then when I get a job, I will schedule my upload around my job schedule. So that's the plan. I hope you guys didn't like zone out because your girl could talk. Y'all know I could talk. But yeah, that's basically it. Like, I wanted this video to be a lot longer than what it was because I've been gone for so long. But this is basically just an update video. So on my next video, we're gonna get back to our original content. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe right now. We're almost at 18K. Y'all, when we get to the 20K mark, oh my goodness, I'll tell you, it's go time, because it should just start happening rapidly from 20K. When we get to 20K, we're gonna be at 50k and then 100k and then it's really up, like, y'all. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe and follow me on my socials. Instagram at @dripdoll_, TikTok at @dripdoll_, Twitter AsiaRiverss with 2 A's. Everything will be linked down in the description box, and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.